getting better. But if we copy things the wrong way, copy things with a bad taste underneath, and we try to make that happen, it's not going to work. So a lot of stuff I'm looking at, sometimes our guys end up, you see a lot of hands in tight throwing. And Mike does it well. Okay? He does. But the background of how many times on the wall, the other stuff, is the reason behind that. If you look at it, his hands aren't that close. But a lot of you try to get them way too close. And we're playing like this. Have a little bit more of a gap. Okay, Austin, have a little bit more of a gap. Get your elbow up. Have more power. Be able to throw with your elbows up and your hands away from your body and your body through it. We're playing like this. And we're doing this. And on cross-handed passes, we're struggling because we're too tight. Guys, if your hands are that close and you're throwing like that, taking a lot off everything. You can get your top hand up a little bit, and you can get your bottom hand down. You're going to have more power. You're going to be able to push through things. You're keeping it in tight, and now we've got a bunch of guys that are playing with their front elbow down and in. Guys, defense that are able to take the ball away and manipulate too much like that. Okay? You try to copy like that, you've got to have another background underneath. You got to hit the wall more. Not there yet. We should have put a little more space between a lot of the short sticks that are here right now. You have it too tight. And I don't know if it's because you're hockey players. I don't know if it's just saying, hey, I want to be like that guy. But we got to slide our hands up just a little bit more. Where should it be? Elbow? The hand? That's the natural spot of it. Okay? That's the natural spot. If we want to get a little bit closer,